we are going to create, I mean, that's what we're aiming at, kind of a transatlantic marketplace. And we are doing that because we believe that would result in hundreds of thousands of jobs on both sides of the Atlantic. So this is really a challenge, but with a big reward, and the big reward would be much more growth and much more jobs.
It does seem to make sense from an economic point of view, with the US economy suffering, European economy suffering. It's actually probably quite a good time to address this. But what challenges are you facing within Europe from member countries? Where are the sticking points as you see them right now?
Well, I believe there are sticking points on both sides of the Atlantic. In Europe, you could hint at agriculture, at health and safety regulations, for example, on GMOs, on hormone beef. But in the American market, we will going to face a lot of problems with public procurement at the state level, regulations on a number of services, non-tariff barriers. For example, the Jones Act, it's about the oldest non-tariff barriers about maritime transport that exists in the world. So you have difficulties on both sides.
And in terms of a successful deal, if we get to that point, how do you think that will actually benefit Europe? Do you think this is actually part of the answer to getting Europe out of the slump?
I hope it would contribute to getting out of the crisis, yes, and that's why I think we should make a maximum effort to come to a result anytime soon. As our American counterparts have been saying, we're going to do it on one tank of gas. Of course, the price of gas has gone down considerably in the US, but that's what we should be aiming at. Let's make a quick deal, a good deal, but let's also try to do it as quickly as possible.
And your thoughts, if I can ask you, just on the UK economy right now, looking ahead to a crucial budget for the country and at a time when actually British finance minister is really sticking up for British interests in Europe?
I believe that Great Britain's place is in Europe. We are their biggest client, and the prospect of having negotiations with the United States is certainly something that will be greeted with a lot of sympathy in Great Britain, and I hope it would contribute to calm down a little bit this open discussion on whether or not they should stay in the European Union. It simply makes sense and best sense for them to stay in.